Thank you for purchasing the TiVo Tarantula 3D printer. In this video, you will learn how to assemble your new printer. But before you start, please note the following suggestions. Working on a flat surface will help to maintain the squareness of the frame throughout the assembly. All the acrylic parts have a brown protection sheet to prevent them from getting scratched. It's easier to remove them before assembling the parts. You will also need the following tools: a square tool, a ruler, cutting tools, medium-size Phillips screwdriver, medium-size flat screwdriver, wrench tool size 21, wrench tool size 6, a tube-shaped one is recommended, ferrules and matching crimp tool. Insulated terminal rings and matching crimp tool. And finally, some grease. Now, gather all the parts and tools and let's begin. Start with the big 20 by 40 and 420 millimeter long profile. And the two small 20 by 40 and 150 millimeter long profiles. Get the four metal corner brackets with the set screws already inserted. Place them first, and then secure them with the small profiles first. If you have the small heat pad, you need to have the small profile centered. If you have the big heat pad, you need to offset them a few millimeters to the back. Tighten the brackets. At the end, confirm that all the profiles are secure, at the correct distance and perfectly square. Next, get the 20 by 40 and 400 mm long profile and attach it to the right side. Also get the 20 by 20 and 400 millimeter long profile and attach it to the left side. To secure them, you will need the cast corner brackets. again, confirm that they are secured and squared. Take the Y-carriage acrylic plate, the acrylic support and bag B4. For the wheels, you need to follow these two sequences. One will be the screw, the wheel, spring washer, the eccentric nut. Pay attention to the orientation of the eccentric nut. The other will be screw, then the wheel, then the first spring washer, then the second spring washer, and the spacer. Take the acrylic support and put it next to the Y carriage. The wheels with the spacer are installed in the small hole, while the wheels that have the eccentric nuts are installed in the large hole. Place the nut on the other side. Tighten the nuts, but without over-tightening them, or you might damage the acrylic. Make sure that all four wheels are approximately at the same height. Get the four L-corner brackets and install the screws and T-nuts. Now, get the X motor mount acrylic plate. Assemble the wheels with the same sequence as before. This acrylic plate is not symmetrical, so please note the correct orientation. Get the stepper motor and install it. Assemble the wheels with the same sequence as before. Thank you. assemble the idlers. Make sure that they can spin freely. You will need one stepper motor, the wire acrylic motor mount, and bag B3. Secure the motor to the acrylic plate with the provided M3 screws. Remember, don't over-tighten the screws. Then, install it on the left back side of the profile. Leave a small distance from the edge of the profile. This will help to tension the belt later on. Thank you. install the pulley. Make sure that the pulley is aligned with the center of the profile. Tighten the set screws and make sure that one of the set screws is facing the flat side of the motor shaft. Assemble the second Y-axis plate. Install it on the other side of the profile. Slide the Y carriage on the Y profile. Adjust the eccentric nut until you get a good grip from the wheels. Move the Y carriage and confirm that all four wheels are turning correctly. Start with one of the side plates and secure it on the profile. Get the screws, spacers, and idlers. Install the second plate on the other side and place the lock nuts. Don't over-tighten these screws, or they will lock the idlers. The idlers must spin freely. Take one of the belts from the bag. Grab a belt and pass it through the interior of the wire profile. One end will go around the idlers and will loop in the Y carriage. Secure it with a zip tie. The other end will go around the motor pulley and loop in the Y carriage. Secure it with another zip tie, and keep the belt tension when you are securing it. You can adjust the tension of the belt by pulling the Y motor mount later on. And slide the X idler mount on the left vertical profile, and slide down the X motor mount on the right vertical profile. Adjust the eccentric nuts until you get a good grip on all four wheels. And do the same for the X motor mount. Get the 20 by 40 and 420mm long profile and secure it to both X mount plates. move the X gantry up and down. Pay attention to the vertical profiles, they cannot move while doing this. Install the last profile on the top. Confirm that the vertical profiles are squared by measuring the distance between them at the top and at the bottom. Use the L corner brackets to secure it. Don't forget to secure it tight and square. Double check by measuring the distance between the vertical profiles at the top and at the bottom. Next, install the acrylic L brackets. At the end, move the X gantry up and down and confirm that it moves freely and that all the wheels are turning correctly. Get the Z motor mount plate and secure it on the top right side of the frame. Remember, don't over-tighten these screws. Get the lead screw nut mount plate and bag B/4/1. Assemble the lead screw nut in the acrylic plate. Also install the M4 screws and T-nuts. Install the lead screw nut mount on the X gantry profile. For better results, you must install the lead screw nut mount on the bottom side of the X gantry profile. Insert the lead screw in the lead screw nut. Check the alignment and adjust the lead screw nut mount if necessary. Place the coupling. But first, check how much the motor shaft needs to go inside the coupling. Tighten one of the set screws on the flat side of the motor shaft. Take the stepper motor and place it on top of the Z motor mount plate. Place the M3 screws, but don't tighten the motor screws just yet. At the end, check if the Z motor mount plate is square. Turn the lead screw so that it can go up into the coupling. As the lead screw goes up, check the alignment and adjust the motor position. Insert the lead screw in the coupling just a bit past the set screw. Tighten the coupling set screws and the stepper motor screws. Before installing the hot end, you need to check a couple of things first. So start by removing the nozzle. For that, you need to hold a heat block with a size 21 wrench and turn the nozzle counterclockwise with a size 6 wrench. Be careful not to damage the temperature sensor or the heater. Get the PTFE tube and make a clean and square cut with a sharp knife. Insert the tube until it reaches the end of the heat break. get a sharpie and mark the position of the tube. Rotate the heat block one revolution clockwise. Tighten the nozzle, making sure that it's tightened against the heat break instead of the heat block. Remember, before your first print, heat up the nozzle up to 200 degrees. And when it reaches temperature, confirm if the nozzle is still tightened. The kit includes four end stops, and in the middle, you can find a temperature sensor. You will not need this temperature sensor for the kit. You can keep it as a spare. The fourth end stop, it's also a spare. Get one of the end stops and place it on the X carriage plate with the metal trigger facing forward. Get the wheels ready. Same sequence as before. Install the wheels that have the spacers first. place the X carriage on the horizontal profile. With the carriage in place, install the other two wheels. Adjust the eccentric nuts until you get a good grip and that all four wheels turn correctly. Get the bag that includes the small fan and install it on the heat sink. Make sure you install the fan with the sticker faced to the heatsink. This is very important. Install the hot end in the X carriage. insert the belt inside the horizontal profile. Loop the belt around the idlers and secure it with the zip tie. Do the same on the other side. Try to give tension to the belt when securing it. Take the heat bed and install it. Get the long M3 screws, the isolation washer and the spring. The isolation washer is placed between the spring and the heat bed. At the bottom, place the adjustment nut. Then, load the springs a little bit. get the metal mount plate and install it on the front side of the right vertical profile using 4 M4 screws and T-nuts. Get the stepper motor and the upper handle. Secure them with 2 screws. Place the gear on the motor shaft, but don't tighten it just yet. Next, get the lower handle and install the guide bearing. Place the screw on the bottom side of the handle and the spring on the top side. Now install the handle. On the top handle, place the pneumatic fitting. Adjust the position of the gear. It must be aligned with the guide bearing. Get the small and stop acrylic mount plates and a couple of switches. Assemble the Y and stop. and the Z end stop. The Y axis end stop is installed on the back side near the Y stepper motor. Turn the lead screw to lower the Z until the nozzle is very close to the heat bed, but without touching it. Install the Z end stop on the back of the right vertical profile and against the X idler mount plate. Make it so that the switch is already fully pressed. Get the main board holder acrylic mount plates and assemble them. Use the long M3 screws with the small standoffs. Now, use the small M3 screws with the long standoffs. Get the front cover and assemble the cooling fan. Next, install it on the right vertical profile. But please note, the part is not symmetrical, so check its orientation. Place the board and secure it with the 4 M3 nuts. Gather the display and the display clear acrylic parts. Remove the piezo protection cover. Use the long M3 screws with the small standoffs. Place the display and secure it using the M3 nuts. Now, use the small M3 screws and the long standoffs. Connect the two flat cables. Place the back cover using the rest of the M3 screws. Insert the tube on the hot end. Make sure you push it all the way until it reaches the mark done a few steps back. Now insert the tube on the extruder side. And this time, don't push it too far. Now take the power supply and confirm that the input voltage selector is correctly positioned for the same voltage you will be using. Crimp all the wires with ferrules or terminal rings as needed. Connect the main power cable in the AC input connector. Please note the earth wire. Connect a 12-volt power cable in the output connector of the power supply. Please note the polarity of the wires. other end of the 12-volt power cable in the main connector of the board. Connect both fan power cables to the output connectors of the power supply. Connect the heatpad cable in the heatpad connector of the board. Connect the hot end heater cables in the E0 connector of the board. These wires don't have polarity. Connect the temperature sensor of the heatpad in the A14 connector of the board. And connect the temperature sensor of the hot end in the A13 connector of the board. Now connect the Z end stop in the minus Z connector in the main board. Also connect the Y end stop in the minus Y connector and the X end stop in the minus X connector. Connect the EXP2 from the display to the EXP2 of the board. Connect the EXP1 from the display to the EXP1 of the board. Connect the X stepper motor cable in the X driver connector. And in the X stepper motor. Connect the Y stepper motor cable in the Y driver connector and in the Y stepper motor. Connect the Z stepper motor cable in the Z driver connector and in the Z stepper motor. Finally, connect the extruder stepper motor cable in the E driver connector and in the extruder stepper motor. To better organize the cables, you can use the provided cable tidy tube and plastic covers for the metal profiles. At the end, place the acrylic cover over the main board. Thank you. Finally, you must plug in the heatbed connector. Pass the cable next to the first heatbed spring and secure it with a zip tie. Move the bed back and forth and check if it moves freely. Apply a little bit of grease along the lead screw. Now, it's time to turn on the printer. Power on the printer and execute the home all access sequence. Once the home sequence is finished, disable the stepper motors. Check the distance of the nozzle to the heatbed. If the distance is small, adjust and level the heatbed. If the distance is high, adjust the Z home sensor and repeat the home sequence. To level the bed, get a piece of paper with a thickness of 1 mm. Then, heat up the bed up to 55 degrees. Move the nozzle to the first corner and adjust the bed height until you feel the nozzle starting to touch the paper. Move the nozzle to the next corner and repeat the process. Do this procedure in all four corners. When done, go back to the first corner and recheck. You might need to go through all four corners more than once. Repeat the procedure in all four corners until the height is stable in all of them. And with that, the assembly is now complete. you will end up with some spare parts like an extra end stop switch, an extra temperature sensor, extra screws and washers, and you will also get a Titan extruder as a gift. And that's it. Your 3D printer is now ready to print. Load some filament and have fun.